If you have been joking, then you change tonight. Let me tell you this. There's nothing wrong in having a relationship with women or men. If you are not careful, it is what you do. Amen, church?
Amen.
You got to be very careful. So that you don't go and force yourself and marry the wrong man.
Yeah.
Wrong man doesn't mean he's a bad man, but it's not meant for you.
Yeah.
You wait. All you want is peace, right?
Amen.
You want joy?
Amen.
You want peace?
Amen.
If something is properly fixed, there will be peace.
Amen.
If something is properly fixed in a place, there will be joy. It will stand there.
Yeah.
You can't carry a square and go and put it in the wrong. It will never fit.
Thank you, Lord.
It's not every man of God you see. Oh, the man is powerful, strong. I want to marry him. Don't do that. He may not be meant for you.
Amen.
Or she may not be meant for you.
Amen.
Don't do that.
Amen.
Amen. It's not every cloth you just put on. Some clothes will not fit you. You seek God's face. If you want, many of us have made mistakes. Many of us, listen to me tonight, you've made mistakes of choices. Do you want to make the same mistake? And God told me, that guy's my husband. Who told you that? You are a liar. God didn't say that. If you repent, God will forgive you. Repent from lies. Because you see, God doesn't speak like that in the first case. What God says is that he that finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains the favor of the Lord. So in the first case, it's the man that finds the woman. That's number one. It's the man that will go to her and say, hey, excuse me, please. I like you. I need to do this and to do that. But then when you look at him and it's your size, you say, okay, let me give him a try. If it's not your size, he just says, thank you, I'm sorry. God bless you. I'll talk to you again. There's nothing wrong with that.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't just, you know, some of you are laughing now, but I'm telling you, it's the Lord's just on the
place.
The man that does not fit you, don't marry him. The woman that does not fit you, don't marry her. Don't say because you have waited for 1 billion years. 1 billion years is like a day before God.
That's right.
Wait! The time is coming.
Amen.
And I tell you, the clock, every veil shall be removed and the real man will be surfaced.
Amen.
Or the real woman will suffer.
Yes.
You have waited for this year, so don't go and put yourself in trouble.
Yes.
Amen.
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 I tell people, don't you ever in your mind think or feel that you want to marry somebody that you just see and you like.
Amen.
The person may not be thinking like that.
Amen.
If you like, put your head on this altar. Anybody that put head on this altar get answered, but not like that one. Put your head on this altar for 40 days and fast, don't eat, and become bonga fish. It may not work. Because you are adding another curse to your life.
Amen.
If you marry the wrong covenant, you add curse. So keep the covenant of God.
Amen.
Can I have a better day?
Amen.
Do you know that it's not only marriage, the same thing with business?
Yes.
Don't do the wrong business. Oh, because I saw brother doing a business of fish and it's exploding. Oh, but let me go and buy a net and ship and boats and put it on the sea and start doing fish. He can be going every day and coming every day and bumper harvest. You can go every second and you catch nothing.
Amen.
Because it's not your call.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Do I have an
amen?
Do you know what the psalmist said in Psalm 2 verse 8? The psalmist said, ask of me, you see, ask, demand, ask of me, and I shall give you the hidden for thy inheritance,
amen,
and the uttermost part of the earth for thy possession.
Amen.
So, what am I talking about, children of God? We are talking about inheritance. Somebody say inheritance.
Inheritance.
Whose inheritance is it? Say Abraham.
Abraham.
Abraham's inheritance is yours.
Amen.
Because Abraham had a covenant with God.
Amen.
Abraham had a covenant with God. And that covenant was made by blood. And that covenant was ratified by Christ.
Yeah.
Amen. It was brought into existence by Christ. Consummated by Christ. So our confession of faith is to claim and possess the Abrahamic covenant blessing. When you keep confessing the faith of Abraham, then a blessing of Abraham, you will continue to receive the riches of Abraham.
Amen.
Abraham's covenant blessing is divided into three. Number one, it is a material and financial blessing.
Amen.
Abraham's blessing is divided into three. It is a material and a financial blessing. I say that again. Abraham's blessing is divided into three. Number one, it is a material and a financial blessing. So don't be afraid of being blessed materially. It is your inheritance. It's yours. Money is yours. Land is yours. Properties are yours. In Genesis chapter 13, verse 2, this is what the Bible says about Abraham. It says Abraham was very rich. All these riches that are happening to Hollywood and everything and everything. All of you will tune TV and be watching Hollywood. It haunts me when I was growing up, I liked films. We used to go to film in Nigeria. We go to film. In fact, my parents used to encourage me also to say, go to film. Just stop sitting down. Go watch film. Indian film or Chinese. Those challenges, you wouldn't know why they are fighting. You just get one. You don't even know what started the fight. One guy, chicken. And then that's when we are on holidays. Then when we come back, we start analyzing the films we watch and all this stuff. And then, you know, we try to create our brain also in love. You know, once you start getting to the age of 10, 12, you know, love starts developing in your heart. Love for opposite sex, even though most of the time it is infatuation. Because I love Indian film because everything about them is love. You will see them singing and dancing, holding each other. So I would say, these people, are they truly, truly love each other like that? But most of the time it's film. You see a man ready to die for a woman because of love. And we watch films. Amen, church. But this is what happened. When I got this revelation that all things are mine. And
amen.
One day I sat down and I saw that film is a drama. All these people, they just, even that leg they kicked, maybe they did it like this. So the machine will carry their leg up. Because I used to practice Kung Fu. I thought those things were real. See, I thought they were real. We want to break stone. We put our hand inside hot sand. Everything peeled. So one day somebody called and said, listen, this thing you're doing, he said, that thing you're doing is drama. They just dramatize it. You are doing the real thing, you will kill yourself. So I stopped it. I stopped watching film because I said, so it's drama. You mean all these guns, they shoot and kick each other. You see one man beating 25 people. Honestly, it was true. I was really ready to grow up like that. But they have to tell me the truth. It's a drama. I said, drama. So I'm not going to do it again. I refuse to go to film. Since I know that it was a drama. Drama means I'm fooling you. Yes, that's what drama. Go and check the meaning of drama. Drama means, in the English word, it means I am fooling you. Whatever you are seeing, I'm just fooling you. It's not real.
Amen.
So I said, instead of me to be going to where they will fool me, I better change another lifestyle. Is somebody listening to God now? But here, God said in Genesis 13:2, he said Abraham was very rich. Rich in what? He was rich in cattle.
Yeah.
Then he was rich in silver and gold. I love people who have dreams of riches. You may not see it yet, but have dreams. I'm going to be rich. I'm going to be rich. I am going to be very rich. Have the dream. Riches come by dreams. Visions. Have vision in your spirit. Stop thinking poverty.
Thank you, Lord.
Laziness, poverty, rubbish, not amounting to anything. Grasshopper mentality. Get it rid of it. Start thinking very wide and big. In fact, there are houses that you are supposed to be thinking about. You have nobody has ever built it.
That's right.
That's the way you should think. Genesis 13, verse 15. Look at what I'm talking about. That dream. God said to Abraham, "For all the land which thou seest." Look at it. Did Abraham see America? Yes. Did Abraham see all these nations? Yes, he did. All the nations, all the land which you see. But how did Abraham see? He didn't see it with his eyes. He saw it with the eyes of the Spirit. That the entire world is going to be his, and it's going to be his descendants occupying it. And Christians don't have that. All we think about is McDonald's. Well, I gotta go to McDonald's. Mem and
hamburger.
Oh, I gotta take some little wine. Is that a vision? Or someone will be thinking, let me just have a good man by my side. Can I be a good woman, just good? Is that a vision?
No.
Man is not a vision. Woman is not a vision. Your vision must be very large. That you cannot leave your vision. Amen.
Amen.
Bible says, as far as you can see, to thee will I give unto thy seed forever. To thee will I give unto thy seed. Now, this is where we come as I begin to close this message. I want to say to you today, did God say seed? Did God say seed? That word seed means hair. Amen?
Amen.
You are the seed that Abraham saw. Please claim it.
Amen.
You are that seed.
Thank you, Lord.
When you see us preaching some radical message and telling you, you can make it, you are going to make it, it's yours. It's because of this seed thing.
Amen.
You know why a man fights for his child? The child is his seed.
That's
why women are very powerful. Why a woman receives the seed? And the seed is inside, she already made up her mind. I'm not giving it to you. I'm going to look for one man. I'm going to give him this baby. And I'm telling you, you can never know that your baby is that baby is yours or not. Only the woman knows. I know you like to laugh, but I'm telling you the reality. Only a woman knows whether a seed that she is carrying is yours or for another man.
That's right.
Only the woman knows.
That's right. That's the truth.
Well, let's remove the sometimes I fear now. Because I don't want us to go into a woman that is so promiscuous. And all. Don't forget about that.
We want to keep it clean.
But yeah, the point I'm making, because we have to look for the point. The point I'm making is that a woman, once she receives a seed, she knows the real person that owns the child that she's carrying.
Amen.
The woman knows. And she'll be looking at you like this. You'll be there cocky as my child. Or, you know, the way the men move.